I'm going to talk to you about Tarlov cysts and back pain in women, an experience in the last 1,000 patients. In fact, I'm around 1,600 patients now that I've seen. And these are almost, 90-something percent women, usually Caucasian women. And they get treated like shit. And they get subject to gender bias and dismissal. And neurosurgeons, orthopedic surgeons just say, these aren't symptomatic and you're mad, you've got no disc herniation, get on with life. And they go to pain anesthesia, who've got nothing to block. So they get put on Neurontin and Tylenol 3s or gabapentin or that pregabalin. And then ultimately, if they wind up on fentanyl patches, there's nothing you can do for them.
These are small cysts that look like a bunch of grapes that occur predominantly at S2, 3, and 4. And as I say, predominantly in women, Caucasian women. And they cause bony erosion of the lamina and the vertebral body. Sometimes they extend through the anterior sacral neural foramen into the presacral space. And they can be severely debilitating, causing either perineal pain, lower extremity pain, or bowel and bladder dysfunction, or all three if people are particularly unfortunate. These cysts can be large, they can be 5, 6 centimeters in size. There isn't a specific size that makes people more likely to be symptomatic or not. It's possible to have a 5 or 6 millimeter cyst that causes symptoms for 13, 14, 15 years. They'll come in on Cymbalta and Neurontin and methadone, and they'll have been told they're mad and dismissed. Often that dismissal is initiated by a radiological report saying these lesions are asymptomatic and incidental. And my hope for this podcast is that we prevent radiologists from saying those words, words often for which there is no basis, and we just prevent that.
They are pathologically a nerve, a spinal nerve that has dilated, filled with spinal fluid, which causes incredible, intractable pain. Nerve pain is very difficult to treat, even with morphine and a lot of really strong narcotics. So there are multi-systems affected by this pathology, including bowel and bladder, so GI systems, urinary symptoms, a lot of symptoms that affect buttocks, hips, legs, feet, as far as nerve pain. So numbness, burning, tingling, nerve pathology, nerve symptomatology, rather. And so the delay in diagnosis often causes more nerve damage over time. So organ failure, system failure. Critically important for them to be reported when they're imaged. Critically important for the medical community to start, particularly family practice, neurologists, neurosurgeons, to start ordering when the patient has a subset of symptoms involving headaches, all the symptoms I've mentioned previously.
Patients with undiagnosed symptomatic Tarlov cysts usually have a long history of pain and may have undergone several technical investigations and interventions. Moreover, patients are generally unable to perform sitting or straining-related activities and therefore may be unable to participate in professional and social life. Patients often become housebound and socially isolated. The patient's suffering is often underappreciated by family, friends, peers, and physicians. As a consequence, depression is a common comorbidity, and the patient's unexplained pain may be mistakenly attributed to comorbid depression.